Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Physics ka Funda. Today I am here to present the third part of class 9 motion chapter. So let's start the video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe Physics ka Funda and please press the bell icon so that you will get notification when I'll upload a new video. So let's start our video today. So here we go. This is the first topic. The name of the topic is rate of change of velocity. So you know what is velocity. I have already explained in the previous video what is velocity. Velocity is what? We have written velocity v is equal to u plus v divided by 2, where u is the initial velocity and v is the final velocity. Now you need to understand what is initial velocity, what is final velocity. Okay, now I'm going to tell you what is initial velocity. I'm going to tell you the concept of initial velocity and final velocity. Understood? Now, what we have to do, you see, initial velocity, for initial velocity and final velocity, to understand these two concepts, now I'm going to give you one example and it will be clear to you. Okay? Suppose a football match is going on. Many players are there. What happened? This is a football. Suppose this is a football. And this football is moving now, definitely. This is a match. So this football will move here to there. In this direction. And another player came and this player kicked the ball. It will go in this direction. This ball has come to this point. Again another player has come. He has kicked the ball like this, in this direction. So it will go to that point. Another player came. He kicked the ball in this direction. What will happen? This ball will come to this place. So I have given four places of the ball. You see what happened. This is the initial case, and in this case, you see, this ball was at rest. Suppose this ball was at rest, and then the player came and he kicked the ball, and that ball has gone to this point. Okay, so when he has kicked the ball, its speed will not be zero. Clear? It was at rest, its speed or velocity was zero. Then somebody came. One player came and he kicked the ball. When you kick anything, when you push anything, when you give force to any object, this object will try to move. As it is moving from rest, you can say that, you see, you can say that this ball will acquire some velocity. It was zero. Now at this point, it will not be zero. It is moving here from this point to this point. It is moving. So in this point, the velocity will not be zero. Clear? Then another person came and he kicked the ball like this. So it is going to this direction, but with different velocity. Why? Because that player may have kicked the ball with some other force. When force changes, the speed will also change. Again, this ball has come to this direction. So this way it is happening. Now you see, if you take from this point, suppose this is the point A and this is point B. Now you want to say that, you want to see from the point A to the point B how much time it has taken. Okay, to move from A to B, how much time the football is taking to move from point A to point B. Clear? So this point will be the initial point. For your case, you have just considered one case. What case you have considered? You have considered from point A to point B. That means A point is your initial point now. In this case, A point is your initial point. Now you see, in the point A, okay, at the point A, your velocity was not zero. Clear? The ball was not at rest. The ball was already in motion. Clear? The ball was already in motion. That means it has some velocity. And this is the initial point. This is the initial point for the football. For your case. For your consideration. Now, you can say that, sir, this was the football. This was the actual initial point. Yes, it was. This was the actual initial point. But actually what we have done, we have considered from point A to point B. That means point A is what? Initial point for your case. as you have considered. Suppose you have not considered this point A, you can consider from there this point to this point, like, okay, this is A, B, this is C and D. Suppose I'm just naming it, this is C and D. If you take the case of C to D, then what we can say that C point will be the initial point, D point will be the final point, because you have considered from C to D. That means initial point and final point totally depends on you, totally depends on your consideration, what you are considering. You wish to calculate the average velocity. Suppose we wish to calculate the average velocity from velocity of the football from A to B. If you are considering from A to B, then you have to take A point, initial point. A point will be the initial point, B point will be the final point. But if you wish to calculate the average velocity of the football, same football, but the point is not AB, point is from C to D. That means this is something else, this is another situation. In this situation, what you have to consider, C point will be what? C point will be the initial point and D point will be the final point, because you have considered, you wish to calculate, you need to calculate the average velocity from C point to D point. That's why C point will be the initial point, D point will be the final point. Now you see, as we have seen that in the point C, the football was not at rest. That means in this point, the football is already in motion. It has some velocity. That means what is initial velocity, you see? Suppose we consider the case from A to B. If we wish to calculate the average velocity of the football coming from A point to B point. See, if we are taking from A to B, listen. If we are taking from A to B, we are not considering these two points. Clear? So, we are not concerned about that what happened to the football in this position and in this D position. Okay? We are taking only from A to B. So, we are concerned about A to B only. So, we will have to understand what happens in case of A and in between A and B. Understood? Now you see, A point is your initial point, B point will be the final point. Final point. You can say final position, initial position. Now you see, at the point A, the football was not at rest. At the initial position, the football was not at rest. That means it has some velocity at this point. That velocity is called initial velocity. Why I am telling this one initial velocity? Because this velocity is the velocity of the football at where? At the initial position. Understood? At the initial position. That's why this is called initial velocity. And initial velocity is always written, listen carefully, initial velocity is always written by small letter u. Clear? Done. Now for your case, which one is final point? Which one is final point? B point. So at this point also, you see, this ball was moving. At this point, the ball has not become rest. The ball is not at rest. That means at this point also, you have some velocity. This point is what? This point is called the final point. So at this final point, whatever velocity this ball is acquiring, you see, this is not at rest. I'm not telling this is at rest. This was already in motion. This was moving the football. As you consider the situation, you all are playing the football, and football is one player has come and kicked the ball. It is moving. At this point, what happened? Another person came and he kicked the ball in that direction. That's why it is moving in this direction. Clear? Now at this point, another player came and kicked the ball in this direction. But that does not mean this ball was at rest here. This ball was moving already. That's why, as anything is moving, that has a velocity. Clear? That means it has a velocity at this position. Which position? At the final position. That's why this is called final velocity. This is final velocity. Final velocity is written by small letter v. Understood? Final velocity is written by small letter v. Initial velocity is written by small letter u. Understood? Initial velocity and final velocity. Initial velocity is the velocity of an object at the initial position and the final velocity is what? The velocity of the same object at where? At the final position. Understood, students? Okay. Now you see, we need to calculate the rate of change of velocity. Before going to explain what is rate, before that we need to calculate what is change of velocity. Change of velocity. Okay. If we consider, you see, if we consider the same case that we considered just now, if we consider the same example, the football is there. Suppose this is the football. This is the football, and this has some initial velocity. Okay. And what it is, we are denoting by small letter u. This is the initial point. Suppose this is the initial point, and at this point the ball is suppose not at rest. The object, you can say object because you cannot specify it is a ball. You have to write what you have to write. You have to write in general. You have to write that it is an object. Clear? The object is here, and this object has an initial velocity of how much? U. Understood? And then what happened? This is moving and it is changed its velocity. Change of velocity we are going to find. Clear? So the velocity, it was u. Now you see, after some time, suppose after time t, the football, definitely it will not be at this position. This will change its position definitely. Why? Because it is moving. Clear? Suppose this football is going in this direction, then after time t, suppose after t time or after 5 second, after 10 second, whatever you can take, but you cannot say it is after 5 second, 10 second. You have to say in general. So after t time, the ball will be somewhere here. The object will be somewhere here. That means after t time, object is here, and this is your final position. And final position velocity is called final velocity. We write by v. Is it clear? Is it clear? Now you see, this is your initial velocity, this is your final velocity, and the time, listen very carefully, the time taken by this object to change from u to v, velocity changed now, this is u, this is v, that what you can say? You can say that the velocity has changed from u to v, understood? Velocity has changed from u to v. As the velocity has changed from u to v, how to calculate the change? I explained in the previous video, whenever in physics you need to calculate the change, you need to subtract the initial velocity, you need to subtract the initial value from the final value. Clear? What is the change you are going to find? Change of what? Change of velocity. So what you have to do? Change of velocity is equal to what? Change of velocity will be is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. I'm really sorry. We need to calculate only what? Change of velocity. How to calculate the change? Final value. Final what value you will take? Change of what you are going to find? Change of velocity, na? That's why you have to say that final velocity minus initial velocity. Clear? Final velocity minus initial velocity will give you what? Change of velocity. And this is change of velocity. Now what we need? We need rate of change of velocity. Now you see, when rate comes, you have to understand, when rate comes in case of physics, you have to divide by time. Rate means per unit time, per second, you can say per second. Ek second mein kitna jata hai? Usko rate bolte hai. That means suppose in 5 seconds you are covering 5 meter distance. So in 1 second how much is, suppose in 5 seconds, okay, in 5 seconds you are covering how much distance? Suppose here to here. In 5 seconds you are covering 5 meter distance. So in 1 second how much distance you have covered? 5 meter divided by 5 seconds. Is it? So it will be 1 meter per second. 1 second mein kitna cover kiya? 1 second mein 1 meter hi cover kiya na? That's why this is called the rate. Okay, when you have to divide by time, then you will get the rate. Rate means per unit time how much you are getting. Clear? So per unit time how much you are getting. Now you see, same case is same here. You see here velocity has changed from u to v. So change kitna hua? How much? Can I wrap it up? Change is how much?
फाइनल वेलोसिटी का वैल्यू कितना था,
v माइनस
इनिशियल वेलोसिटी
u. सो चेंज ऑफ वेलोसिटी इज हाउ मच, v माइनस u, व्हाट एवर बी द वैल्यू, v माइनस u. इज इट क्लियर? v माइनस u, फाइनल वेलोसिटी माइनस इनिशियल वेलोसिटी विल गिव यू द चेंज ऑफ वेलोसिटी. व्हेनेवर चेंज कम्स, माइंड इट, व्हेनेवर चेंज कम्स यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड यू हैव टू सबट्रैक्ट इनिशियल वैल्यू फ्रॉम द फाइनल वैल्यू. So initial value is u, final value is v. Clear? So v minus u will give you the change of velocity. But we need rate of change of velocity. Now to change that much of velocity, see, the ball has changed its velocity. We will say the object has changed its velocity from u to v. And how much time it has taken to change that much of velocity? T time. I have given here now T time. In T time, listen very carefully. In T time, the object has changed its velocity from v to u. That means the rate, how you will calculate? You will calculate the rate of change of velocity is equal to what it will be? Change of velocity divided by change of velocity. Kitna velocity change hua? V minus u. Kitna change hone ke liye ye jo football tha kitna time liya? When you divide
by time, you find the rate. Mind it very, very carefully. You listen. When we divide by time, we are getting the rate. Is it clear? We are finding rate of change of velocity. Rate of what we are going to find? Change of velocity. So change of velocity divided by time will give you the rate of change of velocity. Kitna change hua velocity? How much changed? Velocity has changed from u to v. Change kitna hua? V minus u. V minus u will be the change of velocity we found. And how much time it has taken to change that much of velocity? T time. That's why this rate of change of velocity is written by v minus u divided by t. And one more thing you need to understand now. This rate of change of velocity is defined by one term. That term is called, very carefully you listen, the term is called acceleration. This rate of change of velocity is called, rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Acceleration. A-C-C-E-L-E-R-A-P-I-O-N. This acceleration is what? Rate of change of velocity. Now if anyone asks you to define acceleration of an object, how you will have to define? You will have to define that the rate of change of velocity of an object is called its acceleration. That means acceleration is what? And it is denoted by small letter a. Small letter a. Acceleration stands for a. A stands for acceleration. Understood? A stands for acceleration. And remember, this is always written by small letter, not capital. Clear? So acceleration is what? Physical concept you have to understand. From the physical concept perspective, you have to understand that acceleration is what? Rate of change of velocity. So the rate of change of velocity is written by acceleration, and acceleration is small a. And this is one formula we are getting. A is equal to what? A is equal to v minus u divided by t. A is equal to v minus u divided by t. Acceleration of an object which has changed its velocity from u to v in time t is given by v minus u divided by t. I have explained, you have to watch the video very carefully. I have explained how this formula is found out. Okay, how this formula is, okay? We are getting the formula. A is equal to v minus u divided by t, where a is the acceleration, v is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity, and t is the time taken by the object to change the velocity from u to v. Understood? Now listen, this acceleration may have two signs. Let me write it. This acceleration may be positive or maybe negative. This acceleration may have positive value or negative value. Now you tell me how, when it will be positive. Listen very carefully. Time can never be negative. Understood? time can never be negative. That means time is always positive here. Clear? Time is always positive. That means what you have here, v minus u. If, listen, if the numerator means v minus u. If this numerator becomes positive, then only you will get a positive. Why? Suppose, for example, you have the object. That object has initial velocity, suppose. What is the SI unit of velocity? Meter per second. Suppose it is 5 meter per second. This is initial velocity u. Is it clear? U is equal to 5 meter per second. Now after suppose 2 seconds of time, the object has its velocity of suppose 10 meter per second. It has changed. Kitna change hua? 5 meter per second se 10 meter per second tak change hua. Time kitna laga? 2 seconds. Now if you have to calculate the acceleration of the object, how you will calculate? Acceleration is equal to what? Is it visible? Yeah. Acceleration is equal to v minus u divided by t. And what is the value of v here? V value is 10. This is final value. Minus 5 divided by how much time? 2 seconds. Okay, 2. What it is? 5 divided by 2 will be 2.5 meter per. Here it is meter per second. Here another second. So meter per second, you need to understand this. Let me write very carefully here. Acceleration is equal to what? V minus u divided by t. What is the value of v? 10 meter per second. Is it 10 meter per second? Minus 5 meter per second. So I can write meter per second here. Divided by how much time taken? Time taken is 2 seconds. Is it clear? 10 minus 5 will be 5 divided by 2. Here meter per second is there. This second will come below, na? 1 by second. Clear? Understood? Understood this? Now you see what you have to do. 5 divided by 2 will be 2.5 meter per. How many seconds are there? 1 second and another second. 2 seconds. So it will be S square. Clear? S into S will be S square. That's why you see acceleration very carefully. You listen. Acceleration has SI unit of meter per second square. You have to write SI unit of SI. Is it visible? Yeah. SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square, or we can write meter S inverse 2. If I write second square in the numerator, how you can write? If I write second square in the numerator, it will be M S inverse square, meter per second square. Is it clear? So this is the S. Very carefully you listen. This is the SI unit of what? Acceleration. Is it clear? Acceleration ka SI unit kya hai? Meter per second. Second square, meter per second square. And velocity has SI unit, meter per second. Done? Now you see, this is you are getting what? Positive. Why you are getting positive? Listen very carefully. Why you are getting positive? Because it is 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5 means what? 5. If I tell you here, this object has initial velocity of 10 meter per second. If I am considering another case, it is 10 meter per second, and then after time, suppose 2 seconds, same time, this has changed to 5 meter per second. Now you see your velocity has decreased. Tumhara velocity kya ho gaya? 10 tha, abhi 5 ho gaya after 2 seconds of time. That means velocity has decreased. If the velocity decreases, this is your final point na? This is your final position. This is the initial position. Now if I ask you to find out the change, how you will find the change? Acceleration is equal to v minus u by t. How much v is there? 5 meter per second. Can I write 5? Minus 10 meter per second divided by how many? How much time? 2 seconds of time. Clear? So how much it is? 5 minus 10 will be minus 5 divided by 2 meter per second square. Clear? Now how much you get? Minus 2.5 meter per second square. So as I told you, this acceleration can have two values, can have two things. One, it can be positive. One, it can be negative. When it will be positive, you need to understand. when it will be positive, when the object has increased its velocity, when the object increases its velocity. यहाँ देखो past था पहले 5, then it was becoming 10, so it has increased, but here it was which one? Here it was what? 10 meter per second initial velocity, final velocity is what? 5 meter per second. That means velocity क्या हो गया? घट गया, decrease. When the velocity decreases, when the velocity decreases, then we are getting what? Negative acceleration. Very carefully listen. When the acceleration will be negative, if I ask you, if anybody asks you, then you have to answer that when the object decreases its velocity, then the acceleration will be negative. And when it will be positive, when it has increased its velocity, then it is positive. Now, positive, it's okay, for positive it is called acceleration, no problem. But negative acceleration, very carefully you listen, negative acceleration is called retardation or deceleration. तो डिसेलरेशन और रिटार्डेशन क्या है? व्हाट इज दैट? डिसेलरेशन एंड रिटार्डेशन आर नेगेटिव एक्सेलरेशन. दे आर आल्सो एक्सेलरेशन बट नेगेटिव एक्सेलरेशन. दैट मींस व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज सेड टू बी रिटार्डेड. ऑब्जेक्ट को कब रिटार्डेड बोलेंगे हम? जब उसका वेलोसिटी घट जाएगा. क्लियर? अंडरस्टूड? इफ द ऑब्जेक्ट decreases its velocity, then we say that the object has retardation, that the object has retarded, that the object has decelerated. Clear? That the object has decelerated, or isko bolte hain, the object has accelerated negatively. The object, many terms are there. So you may be confused. I'm telling you, very carefully you listen. When an object decreases its velocity, then the object is said to be retarded because it has retardation, or decelerated because it has deceleration. Deceleration and retardation means negative acceleration, or you can say that the object has accelerated but in the reverse direction. Acceleration in the reverse or opposite, you can say opposite direction of motion. Acceleration in the opposite direction of motion is also called retardation. Clear? Agar opposite ho jayega na, that will be defined by one negative sign. That's why negative acceleration, you have to listen very carefully. Negative acceleration is very, very important. Negative acceleration is called retardation. Negative acceleration is called deceleration. And negative acceleration is what? Negative acceleration is called acceleration in the reverse or opposite direction of motion. Clear? So reverse kab hoga? Where it will be retarded? When the object has decreased its velocity. Jab object kya karega? Uska velocity ghat jayega, decrease karega, tabhi bolega usko retardation. Understood? When it will be retarded? When the object has decreased its velocity. When it will be accelerated in the same direction of motion? This is opposite direction of motion means negative acceleration, okay? If it is same in the same direction, acceleration in the same direction of motion, then it will be positive. Clear? If it is in the same direction of motion, then it will be positive. So this much is there for rate of change of velocity. So rate of change of velocity means acceleration. Acceleration ka SI unit kya hota hai? SI unit is meter per second square. Acceleration can be positive, can also be negative. Positive acceleration is what? Acceleration in the same direction of motion. Negative acceleration is what? Acceleration in the reverse direction of motion or opposite direction of motion. Negative acceleration is also called retardation, deceleration. Understood? And when you will get negative acceleration, when you will get retardation, when the object changes its velocity but in the reverse direction. That means when the object decreases its velocity. When the object decreases its velocity, then we say that the object has retarded, that the object has decelerated if its velocity is decreased. And when it is said to be accelerated, when the object has increased its velocity. Understood? So this much is there for acceleration. Clear? Understood? So I think you have understood what is acceleration. So I think I will have to finish this video here because it will become so lengthy. It's already half an hour. So thank you for watching. Please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get notification. Clear? Thank you for watching. Thank you.